I know you've seen modulation before, so my point here is not to teach you modulation schemes, but rather remind you a couple of key features. So I know that when you took undergraduate courses in communications, you learned about baseband signals, and then you learned about key modulation techniques, such as amplitude or frequency or phase modulation. And the whole idea behind each one of these schemes is that you're modulating the carrier signal, which is my main RF signal, in its either amplitude, frequency, or phase, such that you can encode different bits. In analog schemes, you're not encoding bits, but you can take those schemes and essentially transfer them to the digital domain, and they're now called amplitude shift keying, or frequency shift keying, or phase shift keying, again, depending on whether you're encoding information in the amplitude, frequency, or phase of a signal. For example, in the very simple amplitude shift keying technique, you can give a certain amplitude of the signal for the bit of one, and almost zero amplitude for a bit of zero. And similarly, you can assign a high frequency for a bit of one or a low frequency for a bit of zero. Similarly, you can have one phase for a bit of one and a different phase. Here you can see the phase change for a bit of zero. And all of these techniques have advantages and drawbacks, and the book actually has a pretty good discussion of them. I have some summary in my notes that you can actually take a look in case you need a refresher. But just as one example, amplitude shift keying, which is also called ASK, is a great modulation scheme in the sense that it's very simple to do. I would say people who make receivers for the first time in their lives, they can actually make this thing work. But it suffers from noise, because any noise that you may have on top of your signal will actually show up and perhaps may actually damage the signal-to-noise ratio.